मोस्ट वेलकम स्टूडेंट इन के वी अपर कैम ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। हाउ आर यू? आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू द चैप्टर पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज। वी हैव नो अ लॉट अबाउट पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज इन थ्री कॉन्सिक्यूटिव क्लासेस। लाइक वॉट इज पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज, इट्स कंपोनेंट, फंक्शन ऑफ पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज, पार्टीज सिस्टम ऑफ द वर्ल्ड एंड नेशनल एंड स्टेट पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज। आफ्टर नोइंग ऑल दिस वी कैन से दैट पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज प्ले एन इम्पॉर्टेंट रोल इन डेमोक्रेसी। वी हैव सीन हाउ क्रूशियल पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज आर फॉर द वर्किंग ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी। सिंस पार्टीज आर द मोस्ट विजुअल face of democracy, it is natural and people blame parties for whatever is wrong with the working of democracy. All over the world, people express a strong dissatisfaction with the failure of political parties to perform their function well. This is the case in our country too. Popular dissatisfaction and criticism has focused on four problem areas in the working of political parties. Political parties need to face and overcome these challenges in order to remain effective instruments of democracy. The first challenge is lack of internal democracy. Within parties. All over the world, there is a tendency in political parties towards the concentration of power in one or few leaders at the top. Parties do not keep membership registers, do not hold organizational meetings, and do not conduct internal elections regularly. Ordinary members of the party do not get sufficient information on what happens inside the party. They do not have the means or the connection needed to influence the decisions. As a result, the leaders assume greater power to make decisions in the name of the party. Since one or few leaders exercise paramount power in the party, those who disagree with the leadership find it difficult to continue in the party. More than loyalty to party principles and policies, personal loyalty to the leader becomes more important. The second challenge of the dynastic succession is related to the first one. Since most of political parties do not practice open and transparent procedure for their functioning, there are very few ways for an ordinary worker to rise to the top in the party. Those who happen to be the leaders are in a position of unfair advantage to favor people close to them or even their family members. In many parties, the top positions are always controlled by members of one family. This is unfair to other members of that party. This is also bad for democracy. Since people who do not have adequate experience or popular support come to occupy position of power. This tendency is present in some measure all over the world, including in some of the older democracies. The third challenge is about the growing role of money and muscle power in parties, especially during elections. Since parties are focused only on winning elections, they tend to use shortcuts to win elections. They tend to nominate those candidates who have or can raise lots of money. Rich people and companies who give funds to the parties tend to have influence on the policies and decisions of the parties. In some cases, parties support criminals who can win elections. Democrats all over the world are worried about the increasing role of rich people and big companies in democratic politics. The fourth challenge is that very often parties do not seem to offer a meaningful choice to voters. In order to offer meaningful choice, parties must be significantly different. In recent years, there has been a decline in the ideological differences among parties in most parts of the world. For example, the difference between the Labour Party and the Conservative Party in Britain is very little. They agree on more fundamental aspects but differ only in details on how policies are to be framed and implemented. In our country, too, the differences among all the major parties on the economic policies have reduced. Those who want really different policies have no option available to them. Sometimes people cannot even elect very different leaders either, because the same set of leaders keep shifting from one party to another. Now we know about, we will know about how can parties be reformed. Let us look at some of the recent efforts and suggestions in our country to reform political parties and its leaders. The constitution was amended to prevent elected MLAs and MPs from changing parties. This was done because many elected representatives were indulging in defection in order to become minister or for cash rewards. Now the law says that if any MLA or MP change parties, he or she will lose the seat in the legislature. This new law has helped bring defection down. At the same time, this has made any dissent even more difficult. MPs and MLAs have to accept whatever the party leaders decide. Second, the Supreme Court passed an order to reduce the influence of money and criminals. Now it is mandatory for every candidate who contests election to file an affidavit giving details of his property and criminal case pending against him. the new system has made a lot of information available to the public, but there is no system of check if the information given by the candidate is true. As yet, we do not know if it has led to decline in the influence of the rich and the criminals. Third one is, the Election Commission passed an order making it necessary for political parties to hold their organizational elections and file their income tax returns. The parties have started doing so, but sometimes it is mere formality. It is not clear if this step has led to greater internal democracy in political parties. Many suggestions are often made to reform political parties. A law should be made to regulate the internal affairs of political parties. It should be made compulsory for political parties to maintain a register of its members, to follow its own constitutions, to have an independent authority to act as a judge in case of party dispute, to hold open election to the highest post. It should be made mandatory for political parties to give a minimum number of tickets, about 1/3, to women candidates. Similarly, there should be a quota for women in the decision-making bodies of the party. There should be state funding of elections. The government should give parties money to support their election expenses. This support could be given in kind, petrol, paper, telephone, etc., or it could be given in cash on the basis of the votes secured by the party in the last election. This suggestion have not yet have been accepted by political parties. If and when these are accepted, this could lead to some improvement, but we must be very careful about legal solution to political problem. There are two other ways in which political parties can be reformed. One, people can put pressure on political parties. This can be done through petition, publicity and agitations. Two, political parties can improve if those who want this join political parties. The quality of democracy depends on the degree of public participation. That's all for today. We will discuss next chapter in next video. Thank you.